consideration of your life, and drawing on what you felt, really. But it seems to me that the process was really very similar, and there was a certain precision in observing what you feel, or observing what's out there.
It's an awareness.
And a commitment, yeah. Exactly, and a commitment to that. So that's sort of one comment. And then you talk about the intuition, as if it is sort of something which is out there. We have an access to it which is not sort of conscious access, not an access we have control over in a way. But on the other hand, in your intuitive drawing, you use an immense skill. So you fell on the grounding of skill and commitment and a certain quick pattern recognition of your own skill as well as of the environment around you in order to produce this. So it's not just a loose thinking.
No, it's
a very precise process.
It's a skill, which is why I found that comment so beautiful. It's a misnomer. The intuition is just nothing, you know, just
exactly.
A chance even. But the more you practice it, the more that you're able to pull things that you don't know that are very creative. I think if you stick to producing what you know, that doesn't take you any further. You have to pull in a different process and be unafraid to use that process, and the skill is being unafraid.
But skill is also an accumulation of certain
things. It is, but also the nature of intuition, the idea of using that and not knowing what you're doing, that is the prohibition to drawing. That is why most people don't think they can draw. Because they want to make something they know.
They think they know.
Yes.
Because I mean, knowing is not just thinking that you know.
And you can never, completely reproduce something like
that. Well, I have a question. Actually, sorry. You mentioned you work since